So all pretty comfortable so far for those that have made it through to the semi-finals. Are we going to go through a little bit of nail biting? Well, next it's the women's doubles. The number three seeded pair from Japan, Miyuki, Maeda and Satoko Suetsuna, up against Meiliana Johari and Greysia Poli, the number eight seeds from Indonesia. Players already out on court. Of course, three Japanese pairs in the top seven seeds. So this is a discipline where they are very much in the four. They're facing an Indonesian pair here, Poli and Johari, who have so far this week, Jill, looked pretty solid, pretty comfortable. They're going to, I would have thought, give them a tough time.
Yes, the Indonesians yesterday against the number 16 seeds, Shinta Mulyasari and Yao Lei of Singapore, won in two straight games. In fact, for their two matches, they've only been on court for a total of 56 minutes.
And yeah, we saw their first round together, didn't we?
That's right. That was against the youngsters from Turkey. But as far as the Japanese are concerned, much, much tougher match yesterday against their teammates. An hour and 36 minutes.
Well, here are the two Indonesian players. Well, ranked number eight. We'll see, with a couple of wins here this week. 18-9 win-loss ratio. Only formed their partnership in the last year, and they've been in three semi-finals. Malaysia, Switzerland, and at the Indian Open Super Series. They got to the quarterfinal stage as well at the All England. They've yet to get the breakthrough win. Three finals they reached in 2010. But there's no doubt they can cause the best some problems on their day. But who do they face? Well, I mentioned three Japanese pairs in the top seven seeds, all in the quarters, although Fuji and Kikawa have already bowed out on the other court. Miyuki Maeda and Satoko Suetsuna. As you say, big struggle against Misaki and Takahashi yesterday. Played a lot of matches this year. Not really been in their best form of the year right now, Jill. You know, earlier on in the year, back in May, they were really flying, but over the last couple of months, the results obviously have failed to live up to that kind of billing.
Yes, that's right. Not the best of form of late, but they're a class act.
Well, three times previously they have met. Three times it's been victories to the Japanese pair, and in straight sets as well. They last met in the semi-finals of the Malaysian Open Grand Prix Gold in May. It's Wojciech Osowski of Poland who is the umpire, and Lauren Spester of South Africa who is the service judge. Yeah, the fact that they've won all three will certainly mean the Japanese have an advantage here. Greysia Poli was saying that they are determined to win. Says the last defeat was because they lack patience and they need to be more focused today. Patience is a key word, though, isn't it, in any sport, really?
It is, but especially against this Japanese pair. It's Japanese style, especially with this pair that now back up to number two in the world rankings. They've gone up a place since a week ago. You know, they just like to defend and defend and defend. And it really is. Their match last night just sort of exemplified their style of play. An hour and 36 minutes, because they will not give in, and they just love getting the shuttle back. They don't have much penetration with their attacking play, but defense, they are so solid. So patience, as you say, is going to be a big part of it. But I'm not so sure that, as far as the Indonesians are concerned, I think the way to beat this Japanese pair is to actually take a few risks and really get the net player involved. I think they need to attack, but I think we're going to see a lot of long rallies and a lot of defending.
haven't been too tight so far, have these matches in the quarterfinals. And the previous encounters will suggest maybe this one won't be either. We'll see.
Miyuki Maeda, Satoko Suetsuna, Japan. On my left, Meiliana Yauhari, Greysia Poli. Miyuki Maeda to serve, Greysia Poli, Lavo, Lake.
Four pairs in the top 15 seeds this week. This was always going to be a discipline, the women's doubles, where they would threaten a medal. And you have to say that M.MAEDA and S.SUETSUNA are their biggest threat. Bright idea here for Greysia P.OLII, following the hard smash, trying to then play the delicate one, but just unable to clear the net. That one did, though.
Serves over, 1-2.
Showed some great power yesterday, Greysia P.OLII, in the win over the Singapore pair.
Yeah, it was a lovely way for her to celebrate her 24th birthday, wasn't it? A nice win over Sari and Yaolei. Good power, but she's also got some lovely touch shots.
Sets over, 3-2.
S.SUETSUNA trying to anticipate, stepping forward on the defence.
Here.
Typical play from the Japanese pair. Look, just very, very content to defend. And in the end, it was Johari who ran out of patience.
And patience was the key word, wasn't it? And she ran out of it there. It's so hard, isn't it, when they're both standing back like that. Everything you try just keeps coming back at you.
Yeah, which is why it's so important to involve the net player. You can't be thinking in women's doubles that you're going to hit winners from the back of the court, so you shouldn't be trying to do that. What you should be focusing on is hitting in such a place that your partner will then be able to intercept at the net. Yeah, that's it. That's smashing too much on one individual player. They need more channel attack down the centre of the court. Clever change of pace.
We can see why it gets dispiriting. Credit to the solidity of this Japanese pair. That's why they are so high in the world rankings. That's out. Every point's going to have to come in the hardest possible manner.
Japanese pair caused an absolute sensation at the Beijing Olympics.
That's over, 4-0.
In the quarterfinal stage, they beat the number one seeds, and the pair who were at the time defending Olympic and world champions, Yang Wei and Zheng Yawen.
Yeah, two titles this year, both in May. After 6 months without a win, they won in India. And then they defeated their teammates, Matsuo and Naito in Malaysia.
Sets over, 5-4.
Matsuo and Naito up against the number one seeds. And the winner of this match will take them on. Wang Xiaoli and Hu Yang, who are a very strong pair, Joe, aren't they, the Chinese pair?
It's incredible. Yu Yang and Wang Xiaoli played against each other in the final of the World Championships in Paris a year ago. And promptly both pairs got split up, and they put the strongest player from each of those two pairs together. And they have formed an astonishing pair.
They've won nearly every event they put together. Service, full court by Lavin's best of that. Number of different reasons why a fault could be called. It was above the waist, I think that's what's he suggested.
Yeah, I think that's what he suggested. Got to serve a strike the shuttle below the waist. The racket's got to be pointing in a downward direction. You've got to strike the cork first and not the feathers. Not allowed to stand on the line, not allowed to move your feet. It's all very, very complicated.
You're allowed to breathe though, yeah.
But I should just explain that the waist in badminton is defined a little differently to how you and I would probably define it. In badminton terms, it's below the lowest rib, which means that it can actually be struck quite high in comparison to what most people would define as the waist.
It was Polly and Johari playing the solid defensive tactics, and the patience in the end game lacking from the Japanese, but wasn't far off though, was it?
The smash there from Johari was directed down the center of the court in between the two Japanese players. That's a much better smash. It involves the net player. It's narrowed the angle of reply, and therefore Greysia Poli able to finish off the rally. That's what you've got to do more of when you're playing against players that have such good defenses. Good tactical play by the Indonesians in that rally.
Update from the other court that the number two men's doubles pairs have just lost their first set against Mohamed Hassan and Bona Septano. Maybe an upset possibly on the cards there. Very tight here in the opening stages here in this women's doubles match.
Good change of pace at the front of the court from Satoko Suetsuna. In the defence of these two pairs, isn't there? When the Indonesians are defending, they seem to snatch at the shuttle more. Certainly there from Johari. No panic when the Japanese players are defending. They seem so calm and relaxed.
Away by Johari here.
Sets over 9-10.
They managed to keep pace here so far. Their first World Championships. It was a quarter-final defeat last year for Maeda and Suetsuna. Between the Japanese pair and gap was spotted, wasn't it, at the front of the court.
Yeah, it was nice in the end from Greysia Poli. It's their first World Championship as a pair, the two Indonesians. Both of them have played with previous partners. And it's interesting, they teamed up shortly before the World Championships last year, and because their ranking was so low, they didn't qualify as a pair because they'd only played literally a couple of tournaments, and they decided not to revert back to their old partnerships just for the World Championships, just to come and compete. They decided they wanted to stick with what they were doing, and they knew that this was going to be the pair that was going to have the Olympic campaign. And that takes quite a lot of courage, because of course every player wants to come to the major events, the World Championships.
Who's going to take the interval lead? Johari, and it's Japan who have the slender advantage then. World Championships every year now, this is its 19th edition. First time in London, been twice in Birmingham.
Richard, I always find this quite amazing, sorry to interrupt you. But two Japanese coaches come on and they each talk individually to players, and I find that extraordinary when you've got a partnership they should be listening to the same advice, surely. It's bizarre to me, but it obviously works. Who am I to criticise? They're number two in the world.
But yeah, standard would be for one guy, as you can hear, giving the same message as they are here to Johari and Poli.
How's your Bahasa?
Not up to scratch at the moment. It's about as good as my Japanese, really. Some really long rallies in the first stages of this match.
11-10. Late. Service over, 11-0.
Good smashing from S.SUETSUNA, making Johari. She'd just defended one on her forehand side there across the body, making her defend backhand, making her twist and turn. Oh, that's lovely. Just guiding the shuttle into the open space.
Comfortably. 1 point in it again.
12-13.
Differences between these two pairs at the moment is, given an opportunity at the net, I think the Japanese pair are more decisive.
The opening match with Gu and Tan having struggled so much in their previous matches against Ko and Yu, and it's a similar story here with the Japanese pair having won every time they've met. This first set is a crucial one, really. And as you can see, that is an inopportune moment for Greysia Molly to serve into the net.
She got faulted earlier, didn't she? And I wonder if that's just disturbed her confidence slightly on her serve.
Thank you.
just long, and now it's a 3-point advantage.
She held that serve for a long time, didn't she?
Long again.
Don't understand the tactics of the Indonesians, to be honest, Richard. Because the longer these rallies are, the longer the match goes on. I think the fitness levels of the Japanese players are superior to that of the Indonesians, and therefore, unless they actually go out and try and win it, and win it relatively quickly, do something in the rallies to try and put the shuttle on the floor.
Service fault called
above the waist once again.
Service over, 14-17.
Yeah, this game's already over 20 minutes old. And if you compare that with Lee Chong Wei, who was on court for just 24 minutes to win his two sets. Brilliant from the Japanese too there, Maeda and S.SUETSUNA.
Service over, 18-14.
As soon as they sniff the chance. Deceptive little drop shot. And they're easing away suddenly. From 10-0, it's 19-14. Game points have arrived.
20 game points, 14.
Desperately close.
Service over, 15-20.
What a way to end the game. Another fault on Greysia Poli's serve.
Miyuki, Maeda, Satoko, S.SUETSUNA, 21-15.
Well, that's cruel, I suppose, on the Indonesian pair. But in the end, it was fairly comprehensive for M.MAEDA and S.SUETSUNA. The advantage as the two coaches. to their two players. Eventually, they just got worn down, you feel, there, Greysia Poli and Miyuki and Johari.
Yes, I do. You know, the longer rallies went on, I know we've used the word patient before, and then we've got to remain patient, but, you know, that to me is not the way they should be playing.
By the way, Berwyn Mogensen hit back in the second set, 21-18. They took it to their indecisive third. They've been spoken to by their respective coaches. They plenty discuss between each other as well. But what can these two do differently, Gio, now? I mean, they've tried to be patient. They've been worn down by this Japanese pair. They've never won a set against them, never mind won a match against them. How do they get through this and try and make a real fight of it?
Well, I think they really have got to be more thoughtful about the placement of their attacking shots. I said in the early stages of that opening game, they were hitting too much on one of the Japanese players or the other. Now, what they need to do is be far more precise in their attacking play. I think, in general terms, they need to cut down the angles more to get their net player involved. I don't see them hitting winners from the back of the court. So the whole focus should be to set up the net player. Now, that's better. That's a good smash, the channel attack, as I call it, down the center. Slight hesitation between the two Japanese players. Who's going to go for the one directly in between them? Now, had that have come back, the net player should have been able to intercept. Oh, my goodness.
Got that one right out of her face, didn't she, Johari?
Movement from the net player as well, the Indonesians.
Johari now off the floor. Incredible rally. We've seen a few of them, haven't we, in this match already. Normally the Japanese pair have come through them. And that's long. Towards the face.
I don't think she knew much about that one.
Thank you. Service over. 1-0.
Look how static Polly is at the front of the court. She needs more movement. Yeah. Well, that's the problem to me. It's very difficult to intercept from a standing position. You really need, we've seen it beautifully demonstrated in mixed doubles, Margin. Was it yesterday evening
we were
watching?
Yes, it was, yeah.
Margin and her movement off the shuttle as her partner's about to hit from the back of the court. She's coming back, then moving forward, moving from side to side. And I'm just not seeing that movement at the moment from the Indonesian players, from the net player.
Yeah, you can see the middle of the white line. She's hardly stepped either side of it. Fabulous. Seems like every time they've got to play a winner, they've got to play one of those beauties.
Service over, 2-0.
You enjoyed that one, didn't you, Jill?
Yeah, that was super. That was a lovely angle.
For the taking here.
Service over, 3-0.
Plenty behind this as well. Just outside the top five with 206 kilometers per hour for Greysia Poli.
Serve. Yeah, more decisive from the front of the court, M.MAEDA. Yeah, moving forward as she hits the shuttle.
Yeah, there's not a huge gulf, is there, between these pairs? It's only a marginal, maybe 5-10%, but it's enough for them to be decisive. Look at that.
That's incredible play from M.MAEDA.
7-3.
Now we rarely see that from the Indonesians. Suddenly one of them just taking the risk, taking the half chance to move forward and try and intercept.
point.
Sets over 4-7.
Meada nearly got there. Says it all, doesn't it? And not for the first time in this match, Greysia Poli with an error on serve. She's been called a couple of faults as well. Resistance has been broken a little earlier in this set. I mean, they've won some terrific points, haven't they, Johari and Polly? But the problem is that they have to keep coming up with stunning shots.
Yeah, got back very quickly there, Greysia Poli. Did well.
6-9.
Oh, that's it. That's nice.
8-9.
You know, when I see a defensive shot like that, where they're turning the shuttle, keeping it much flatter over the net, using the mid-court area, I get totally bewildered as to why all four players on court are so content just to lift to the back of the court time and time again within the rallies. Quite obvious that when they do try and do something with defence, it's very much to their advantage. Greysia Poli's static at the front of the court again, that's better.
Oh, nice little run just when it looked as if it was all slipping away from them. 4 points in a row, back to 9-all in this set. By the way, it's 14-all in the final set, and Matthias Bowen and Morgensen, the Danes, the number two seeds, up against Bonaseptano and Mohamed Arsan. That's why you're hearing a lot of noise from around this arena, but not necessarily from this match.
Yeah, net player involved, change of pace.
And this little run's come from nowhere in some respect, hasn't it?
Well, six straight points.
Yeah.
11-9 interval.
Didn't see that coming about 5 minutes or so ago. Ah! 40 minutes already in this match. Was it a simple case there of the Indonesians changing things, or did the Japanese pair that I thought just their defensive work and some of their play just became a little sloppy?
Combination of both, I suspect. I mean, I thought there was better defensive work from the Indonesians. A couple of times they tried driving the shuttle, turning it instead of just lifting. They also got the net player involved a little more, and one hard push and then a check shot just to take the pace out of the shuttle. But the key is to involve the net player in the first place.
11-9, late.
That back line.
That super run from the Indonesian pair of G.POLII and G.POLII. S.SUETSUNA with the winning shot there. Missed a fair bit of 2009 after she tore a cartilage, had to have an operation. Judgment.
Especially M.MAEDA. I think she's the one player on court that's very positive from the front of the court.
Yeah, she made a few mistakes, but she's looking to vary it up, isn't she, around the net and be decisive.
Lazy shot from G.POLII, turning to play a backhand from the back of the court. played herself into trouble, in all honesty, by playing the cross-court shot from the back in the first place. Yeah, real threat once again from M.MAEDA.
15-12.
After this drop shot, look at her movement. She's going forward, she's anticipating the net shot. And the sheer threat of her being there forced her opponent into error.
So this mini revival from the Indonesian pair is quickly dissipated, hasn't it? Just had that run in this game where you thought, well, maybe we're heading for a third set, but I suppose they could string another few points together, but Japanese players here back in the groove.
Yeah, in she goes again. Oh, that's nice.
You probably can't hear Laren Beston calling that again against Greysia Polli, and she's getting extremely frustrated, as you would understand. The cacophony of noise is because the Danish pair of Bowen Mogensen have saved a couple of match points and then have got one of their own in the men's doubles match on the adjacent court.
At the net, who's making the difference once again? It's M.MAEDA. Nicely played from Greysia Polli.
14-17.
More commitment at the front of the court. That was good.
Towards the semi-finals here, M.MAEDA and S.SUETSUNA. Bronze medal guaranteed for reaching the last four. Huge roar, obviously, in the arena because the number two seeds have been knocked out, Jill, in the men's doubles. Two more points for victory required for M.MAEDA and S.SUETSUNA. Match points. And once again, it's the pair that have had the Indian sign over their opposition in previous encounters who are grinding them down again. One match point saved.
Service over, 16-20.
Four more to go though. Been a match full of these kind of rallies.
Still movement at the front of the court from M.MAEDA. It's good to see.
Japan's top women's doubles pair are into the semi-finals. You have to feel for Johari and Polly. They just struggle to break them down. The patience that Greysia Polly was talking about before the match, it was severely tested by a very resolute and skillful performance from M.MAEDA and S.SUETSUNA. And what a mouth-watering prospect they potentially could have in the semi-final against the number one seeds. 21-15, 21-17, the final score. Yeah, Wang Xiaoli and Wu Yang, the world number one pair right now. Of course, these are the number two pair, and they could well meet in the semi-finals if Wu and Wang beat another Japanese pair in Matsuo and Naito.
Yeah, and I think it would be a very different game if it was against the top Chinese pair. Very different tactically. The top Chinese pair will want to attack. They're a very, very dynamic pair. And I think that this Japanese pair, if that semi-final comes about, their defensive play will be tested to the limit.
Yep, there we go. They might be taking on their compatriots mightn't they? Just confirmation then that it's Maeda and Suetsuna through to the semi-finals. You'd fancy it would be Wang Anu, given their form over the last 12 months, that they would meet in the last four, but you never know. But comprehensive, wasn't it? Straight sets victory for Maeda and Suetsuna.